Consider the function f, which maps the set with elements 1, 2, 3, and 4 to the set with elements 0, 1, 2, all the way through 9. Number 1, how many total functions are there? If we take a look at the two-line notation of the function f, notice how we have the elements from the domain in the first row, and we'd have the elements from the range in the second row, which must come from the codomain. Notice the codomain contains 10 elements, and therefore there are 10 choices for the first output, 10 choices for the second output, 10 choices for the third output, and 10 choices for the fourth output. Using the multiplicative recounting principle, the total number of functions is equal to 10 to the fourth, or 10,000. And now for number 2, how many of these functions are strictly increasing? A function is strictly increasing provided if a is less than b, then f of a is less than f of b. So going back to our two-line notation, the function is going to be strictly increasing if the elements in the range or the second row are increasing. And notice every time we choose 4 elements from the codomain, we can rearrange them in increasing order and create an increasing function. And since there are 10 elements in the codomain, and every time we choose 4 of them, we can form a strictly increasing function, there are 10 choose 4 strictly increasing functions. And 10 choose 4 is equal to 10 factorial divided by the product of 10 minus 4 factorial and 4 factorial, which is 10 factorial divided by the product of 6 factorial and 4 factorial, which is equal to 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 factorial, all divided by the product of 6 factorial and 4 factorial, which is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Simplifying, 6 factorial divided by itself simplifies to 1. In the denominator, we have 4 times 2, which is 8. 8 divided by 8 simplifies to 1. 9 and 3 share a common factor of 3. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 3 threes and 9. We are left with 10 times 3 times 7, which is 210. There are 210 strictly increasing functions. And then number 3, how many of these functions are non-decreasing? A function is non-decreasing provided if a is less than b, then f of a is less than or equal to f of b. So for a function to be non-decreasing, it can be increasing or constant. To answer this question, we'll have to use the method of stars and bars. Let's do this on the next slide. So using the stars and bars method, because we have 4 unknown outputs, we have 4 stars, and because there are 10 possible outputs, or we can say 10 distinguishable outputs, we have 9 bars. Remember, the number of bars is always 1 less than the number of distinguishable objects, or in this case, distinguishable outputs. Each bar represents a switch from one output to the next, which is why if we have 10 possible outputs, we have 9 bars. From here, every string that we form of length 13 with 4 stars and 9 bars will represent one non-decreasing function. Let's look at 2 examples. Looking at the stars and bars charts below, each stars and bars chart will give us the outputs of a function in which the function is non-decreasing. So for the first stars and bars chart, we have a bar, which indicates we switch from the output of 0 to 1, and then we have a star. The star indicates 1 is the first output in two-line notation. Then we have 2 bars, which means we switch from 1 to 2 and then 2 to 3. Then we have another star, which indicates 3 is the second output in two-line notation. And then we have 4 bars, which represents 4 switches. We switch from 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 to 7. And then we have a star, and therefore 7 is the third output. And we have 2 more bars, which indicates we switch from 7 to 8 and then 8 to 9. And we have 1 more star. 9 is the final output. Notice how this function is non-decreasing. Let's look at one more example. For the next stars and bars chart, we have 2 bars, which indicates 2 switches. We switch from 0 to 1 and then 1 to 2, and then we have a star. 2 is the first output. Then we have a bar. We switch from 2 to 3, and then we have 2 stars, which indicates the next 2 outputs are 3. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stars, which indicates 5 switches, and therefore we switch from 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, and 7 to 8, and then we have a star, 8 is the fourth output, and then we have a bar, which indicates we switch from 8 to 9, but there are no more stars, and therefore we're done. Looking at the outputs, once again, this is a non-decreasing function. The number of non-decreasing functions is equal to the number of strings of length 13 that we can form with 4 stars and 9 bars, which is equal to the sum of the stars and bars, choose number of bars, which is 13, choose 9. 13 choose 9 is equal to 13 factorial divided by the product of 13 minus 9 factorial and 9 factorial, which is equal to 13 times 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 factorial divided by, well, 13 minus 9 is 4. 4 factorial is equal to 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. We still have times 9 factorial. Simplifying, 9 factorial divided by itself simplifies to 1. In the denominator, we have 4 times 3, which is 12. 12 divided by 12 simplifies to 1. 2 and 10 share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 5 2s and 10. We're left with 13 times 11 times 5, which is equal to 715. There are 715 non-decreasing functions. I hope you found this helpful.